What is domain-driven design, or DDD? Let's find out in today's video. Domain-driven design, or DDD, is a design pattern that defines the rules that allow the code to be organized according to specific rules that serve to better organize the code's responsibility. Here's a personal story. One day I decided to take a vacation. This time, I'm going abroad. What an unpleasant surprise it was for me to learn about the difficulties it entails. This is both a passport and a visa. Onerous but necessary, this has made my country safer, and I now know where the law is and what language it is written in. Country borders can be compared to domains, each with its own set of rules and structure. The border is made of a facade that allows communication between the two countries. Rules. We break down the parts of the code related to a given topic, and these parts are domains. We split the domain, infrastructure, and SDK parts within the domain. The domain has access to the domain, infrastructure, and SDK. The infrastructure has access to the infrastructure and the SDK, while the SDK only has access to itself and does not use any external solutions. The domain shows the business logic and the infrastructure logic related to the library we use. Domains only communicate with each other through facade or by observer pattern. Domain-driven design has many advantages. Among them are the following: greater code cleanliness, greater code independence, easier transitions to other solutions, easier separation of the structure for microservice. However, DDD is not a perfect pattern. The disadvantages of this pattern includes more code, contradiction with official documentation, problem with layer classification, example in the case of validation, problems with domain classification in case of logic using several functionalities. In conclusion, DDD is a code ordering formula that significantly increases the readability and the scope of responsibility of a given part of the application. However, writing with these rules takes longer and requires many more files. There is also a problem with recognizing what belongs to which domain and to what layer. If we can spend more time, it is worth using this standard, but on the condition that every programmer knows it and the whole team adopts fixed rules so that they do not get lost in their own and other code. We recommend to use DDD with another pattern such as hexagonal architecture, event storming, and command bus. What other design patterns have you used DDD with? Let us know in the comments below. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next one.